time. OTP.
Here we are.
You ready?
Yes.
All right, let's do this.
Exactly.
All right, so I look down at the end of the TV version of us, and I realize that until things get rolling, things like this can be talked about. Artemis says, I wonder if they make Spanx for dogs. My French bulldog is getting a belly.
Can I say something? Nothing is cuter than a French bulldog's belly. So
And a lot of people talking about how fast this president has gotten running.
Yeah.
And you made the comment that's exactly what he needed to do. You've worked for people who have done it that way and who have not done it that way.
And there's two things that are important about that. First of all, there's just the practical reality that, time is very short. Okay, there's a four-year term, but realistically, you've got to get on with it. Some of these things take time to, come to the point where people feel the real-world effects. So that's the practical reason. But also, these first impressions really count. And just creating that impression of energy and action will last you a long time.
Yeah. You know, we haven't seen yet, Megan, exactly how the confirmations will continue to stack up, because we've only seen 2 out of 15 so far. Mm-hmm. But I'm curious, just looking at this, how does this help the Democrats whatsoever?
I don't think it does, but obviously I'm a Republican, so maybe I'm seeing it through that lens. But I think the more you grandstand for the camera, the more you delay the inevitable, the more ridiculous you look. And I think, I know it is hard for a lot of liberals to accept, and I've really hit my limit with the crying and the hysteria and the pearl clutching. I've given everyone enough time to be sad about your president, you know, not becoming elected, but you have to move on and fight for the change that you want. And doing it this way, not only do I think is short-sighted, but I think actually could have the reverse effect.
Democrats have to move on.
No, Democrats don't have to move on anymore. Republicans didn't have to move on for the last 8 years. I don't remember Republicans rolling up their sleeves and working with Democrats to get a Supreme Court justice that Orrin Hatch said would be a great Supreme Court justice confirmed just because Barack Obama appointed him. Suddenly they said, I remember other senators saying that he might not even, if she were elected, they might never give a hearing to a Supreme Court justice. So the bottom line is you constantly have Republicans who were complaining and obstructing whenever a Democrat was in office, who are now saying, oh, heavens to Betsy, I can't believe the Democrats aren't falling in line. It happens all the time.
Yeah.
And Democrats understand and learn their lesson from Republicans, which is that the more they obstruct, the better they'll do in the midterms. It's exactly what the Republicans did. They obstructed and obstructed, and they got what they wanted first in 2010, then again in 2014, and now inevitably they got a president elected. So if you're a Democrat, why would you fall in line?
But do you see anyone ever breaking that?
No. I don't, because that's not how Washington works. It's unfortunately not how Washington works.
That's what this election was about. I totally agree with you. That's exactly how Washington works. And I said it during the show, going there and just seeing the building boom, the money, the largesse in Washington.
With our money.
And people coming in from outside. And you know, I was in the audience in the way back during that speech, and he reached out over the crowd in front of him and said, this is for you out there. And I think, you know, whether you buy into that or not, there's a lot of people buying into it.
All right.
They look at this gridlock and they say,
but that's what Obama was voted on. I'm sorry, but that's what Obama was voted on in 2008. Remember the hope and change, we're going to get rid of the divisiveness in Washington. That same rhetoric
Trump wants to get rid of everybody.
Wants to drain the swamp.
Okay, but he's draining the swamp by putting in who? People from Goldman Sachs as his Treasury Secretary?
Non-politicians.
Jeff Sessions, Tom Price, I can go on.
It depends what they do. I think that is a bit of a superficial way of looking at it. Like, if they end up implementing reforms that actually deal with the lobbying and deal with the way that contracts are awarded to the same old people and all that corruption that goes on, even the people from Goldman Sachs could end up delivering on draining the swamp,
depending on what they do. But I've said this from day one. He will easily win re-election. Easily win re-election in places like the Midwest and frankly more than just the Midwest if he comes through on his promise to bring back jobs. And if he comes through on his promise
that's right.
It's over.
Well,
I mean, it's
Barack
as simple
Obama
as that.
Easily won re-election and he didn't come
but
through
can
on
we just
bring
nothing
jobs.
Nothing will please liberals. Nothing will please you guys. It doesn't matter who he puts into place. He could put in the most moderate Republican ever. You guys would find a problem
Republicans?
No, I'm just going to go. I let you talk. Let me talk, okay? I'm going back to where every single Republican candidate is evil. Every single Republican candidate since Bush is Hitler. Every single Republican candidate is the worst thing that ever happened. And now that you actually have a populist, more unorthodox candidate, I feel like a lot of liberals are crying wolf. Do you know how many liberals are coming up to me saying, oh, your father, people like your father, I wish I should have listened to him. You get no sympathy from me, because when all Republicans are evil, then nothing else can possibly happen. And nothing will please the left. Nothing. It doesn't matter if he put into place the most moderate Republican that exists. Everyone would have a problem with it, and I bet Cory Booker would grandstand against it.
Well, so wait a second. Let me just respond to that, because when did Republicans fall in line about with anything that Barack Obama did? When did Republicans stand up and say, you know what, Barack Obama, you just got elected in the largest landslide, I believe, since Ronald Reagan, if not even before that. We're going to fall in line. We're going to support all of your nominees. Everybody's great. We're going to get behind every part of your agenda. It didn't happen, Megan.
It took less time. You guys have only approved two. I mean, there was, what, 17
on the day of the inauguration. Six or seven on the day.
Did they fall in line, though, on one policy issue?
I think they gave him, I think Republicans, starting with, by the way, since you always love to bring up my father, starting with my father on the night that he, twice on the show today. So when he did on election night, saying that this is an important moment for America, we should accept what has happened. Like, the rewriting of history is what has gotten Democrats into trouble for so long. And again, I think, as Harris pointed out, there were seven on the inauguration day when Obama was in office. And the idea that every single pick, no one can find one pick that liberals are just semi-okay with. And I just don't understand. He's going to put unorthodox people in his cabinet. He's an unorthodox candidate. And I just don't know exactly what you want instead other than liberals.
Well, Senator McConnell,
what did you want besides conservatives? I mean,
Senator
honestly,
McConnell,
what was the answer?
Said that he wasn't fans of all the ones that Barack Obama wanted when he first got into office, but they moved forward. Go ahead, Steve.
I was just going to say that I think, you know, they'll get confirmed in the end, but I think the really interesting thing for me was just watching that interaction with Trump and the people around the table, Nancy Pelosi and the others. Just there's something about his personality and the way he is and this unorthodox way he speaks. I genuinely think it might just do the trick. The way he talked about a beautiful relationship and all that language we all thought was fun, actually, just precisely because it's so different.
So
it might
different.
Just move the parts around in an interesting way.
So there are so many people that have come and told me a personal story very similar to that, of the idea that, oh, Trump, you know, he's an awful guy. We were doing this deal, and whether they were a contractor, they were a plumber, they were supposed to be delivering something, they were summoned to his office, they were furious with him, they thought he was awful, they met on him one-on-one, he charmed the socks off them, and they ended up walking away thinking they got the better of them. Him. They walked out saying he was never going to agree to anything. He said he was going to cancel the whole contract. In the end, we made a deal and I got this amount of money. And they left thinking that he was A, nice, and B, they had made a good deal. And I've heard the same story from so many people with just different facts. I'm like, do you realize this is his MO? And I guarantee you, this is what we're going to hear. People hate him. They go into the office. They sit there. They went there reluctantly. He's so awful. They sat down.
Look at the union leaders at the White House. I don't know if they fall into the category that they didn't like him, but they certainly had, you know, a position of, okay, we're going to meet this new president who's not a politician. We're at the White House. What's this going to... When they came out, they were effusive, but not just because they met somebody that they thought they liked, who respected them, so on and so forth, because they did describe that, but that they thought they could deal with.
Yeah.
Deal. You know, get things done. So I know you guys will share in my mutual joy that this word has only one P. Striper's easy. I looked down at first. I was like, what? Trump will eventually transcend all previous arguments from the left. A new world is emerging minute by minute. I'm just going to read these real time. MRM Coop says, I'm so over the Clintons and the Bushes. No more dynasties, please. We have a record number of people on our live chat right now, or close to
it. A lot of people feel that way about dynasties in America. I think that was one of the main things Trump did, is completely just cut down
from
at the
both
knees
parties.
From both sides, that's not something Americans want anymore.
Okay, so I'm looking at these. Oh my gosh, there's so many. Steve, you're watching this come in.
Yeah. I'm admiring your dexterity.
I'm trying to slow it down. 218 comments. My Voice 33 says, I can't keep up today. I can't keep up today, because they scroll in at hundreds at a time. Julie, Congress rubber stamped almost everything Obama did. They seemed to be afraid not to. Silver Money Man, your thoughts?
They did? I mean, when Democrats were in charge, yeah, they worked with the president. When Republicans were in charge, of course they did. And they filibustered everything and prevented a Supreme Court justice from going on the bench, from even getting a hearing. I mean, my goodness, I don't know how much worse it can get than that. not even a hearing. So I don't recall, you know, the Republicans ever joining with Barack Obama to, quote unquote, make America great again. It never happened.
Steve, how important do you think it is? I mean, Brexit now, people are looking at as it kind of comes into full fruition. How important is it that we come together as a nation? Because you've been in a nation divided.
It's
you know
really
divided, like.
And it still is, and it's more than 6 months after, and there's still incredible bitterness about that vote. And that was a cleaner result, if you think about it, because it was a 52-48 decision, and there was no electoral college or anything like that. It was a really clean result, and still there is intense division and bitterness and anger. And I think the difference is that the whole process is delayed because it's this long negotiation and people can't see the positive results quickly. Whereas at least with this election, if Trump does what he's supposed to do, people might say, okay, I hated him, I was angry about the result, but you've got to give it to him. Jobs are coming back or whatever. If that starts to happen, then I think the country can come together and move on.
All right. Good to have you.
Thank you.
And CrowdPack, you're doing some stuff with like elections all around the world, so it's really interesting. Good luck with everything.
Okay, thank you.
Come back anytime.
See you soon.
We'll see you tomorrow.
Thank you.